In an interactive project, there may be some actions that repeat. For example, when you follow the mission,
drag the chameleon to the pink flower,
and drag the chameleon to the flower, it changes its color that corresponds with the flower. The correct sound is played.
It turns pink.
Also, an annotation appears. You collect 10 points. And the mission disappears.
Drag the chameleon to the yellow flower.
It turns yellow.
Drag the chameleon to the blue flower.
It turns blue.
When many objects do the same tasks like that, it'll be a waste of time setting actions for each one. Moreover, the events, actions of each object look complicated. In this case, you should consider using the Advanced Actions feature. It allows you to define complex actions at one time and reuse them easily. Let's try using the feature in this sample project. First of all, to add advanced actions, navigate to the Properties pane, Interactivity tab, Events, Actions section, and click this button. Alternatively, open the Questions tab, select Advanced Actions. Then, the Advanced Actions dialog appears with three sections: Action Name, Parameters, and Actions. The first section shows the name of an advanced action. Click here to add a new one. Type its name, for example, on correct. Now, you can use the commands to rename, duplicate, or delete any advanced action if needed. Next, if you want to add a value to the action, and reuse this value for other objects afterward, pass it to a parameter. Parameters will be used as references for actions, in the next part. To add a parameter for an advanced action, click this button. Enter the parameter name in the name box. In this sample, you take advantage of the change object state action. So, you can name the parameter change state. Next, select the corresponding type from the list. Each added parameter must be in proportion to the created action depending on your aims. For the change state parameter, choose its type as control state. After the object changes its state, you want to show and hide other objects. To do that, add more parameters, name them, and choose their types. You can rename, change parameter type, change its positions, or remove it by clicking one of these buttons. After finishing adding parameters, click this button in the Actions section to add actions. For example, you select the Change Object State action. Then, click this one, select the object that changes state from the object drop-down list. Then, select the Param checkbox, choose a parameter from the list. Note that the action list can include actions that don't use the parameters. Repeat the process to add more actions as you want. When it's done, click to save and finish. Now, it's time to apply the advanced actions to the onCorrect event of the corresponding objects. Click here and add the advanced action. Then, choose the advanced action you have created. As can be seen, parameters that have already been added appear. Simply click the drop-down arrow to select the suitable values. It's easy and quick now to apply the same actions to many objects or slides. By doing so, it will work the same way as normal actions shown at the beginning of this video. That's how to work with the Advanced Actions feature in ActivePresenter. Thanks for watching.